South Africa has reopened the more than 20 land borders after a 15-day closure. This was the government's strategy to fight the second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic. South Africa is also a host country to thousands of migrants, but one of the busiest borders with Mozambique got to a very slow start. Not many migrant workers rushed back to South Africa on the first day. Here's Matuba Malatshi's report.
The Lebombo border gate with Mozambique opened at 6 a.m. in the morning on Monday, but hours later, even the Home Affairs Minister arrived to an almost empty reception area.
And we have opened at 6, so it's 3 hours.
Almost 4.
It's almost 4 hours. And within 4 hours, how many people have visited?
The officials blamed the bad weather for the delayed entry of thousands who were expected. But on the South African side of the border, informal traders say their lives are hanging by the thread. He says people who buy from his food stall are locked behind the border gate. He says border gate officials don't buy his food and relies on people who come from the other side to buy his stock.
The Lebombo border between South Africa and Mozambique is not having an influx of people who usually have work here in South Africa, and people are alluding that fact to the expensive COVID-19 certificate that people need to move into South Africa. The only flow we've seen so far is that of the river you see behind me, and these trucks that are moving in and out of South Africa into Mozambique, they've never really been affected by the closure of the borders, but the people who actually make a living from Mozambique into South Africa, we have not seen them coming in their numbers as usual.
The Home Affairs Minister says the COVID-19 negative result is not negotiable to enter South Africa.
Unfortunately, this matter was debated very thoroughly even during the first phase in cabinet. There's no way government can pay for people to visit.
Yeah.
It happens no way in the world that we pay you money in order to visit us.
Sure.
I mean, it shouldn't. So any person who wants to visit South Africa, unfortunately, will have to produce that certificate.
A little further from the border into South Africa, job losses and a strained economy. This man owns this complex. He says the closure of the borders added to the depression caused by the pandemic.
The closure of the borders has impacted the business drastically because especially this town relies on the community and of Rosana Garcia and a lot of people coming through the border going to Joburg and so forth. The closure of the border has affected the business drastically. Business, in terms of business, we're down to about 15 to 20% at this point in time. Once the border opens, there's a lot more flow.
South African taxi operators here at the border say they too are affected by the closed borders, and with no migrants in sight, more trouble is looming for them. He says he's been waiting for his first passenger since 4 a.m., but no one has come from the other side of the border. There are plans for the South African economy's recovery, but there's definite uncertainty for those who rely on a thriving economy. From the Lebombo border post in South Africa, I am Matuba Mahlatshi.